There's a wonderful story today in the Holy Gospel I've just now sung in Latin at the altar, and it's a story of the Holy Innocents. Oh, when our Lord was born, he was born to be the King of Kings, and so there were kings from the east, from Iran that came, or Persia, and they brought gifts with them, and we have their feast day on Epiphany, which is the sixth day of January. And they were wondering where the king was, but star led them, but they couldn't tell exactly because Bethlehem was very near to Jerusalem, just a couple of miles away. Well, so they went to see the king there in Jerusalem, and he was a particularly wicked king, even for a king, I mean, and he murdered a lot of people. He was a tyrant or a dictator, and his name was Herod, and he got very jealous if he suspected that anybody else was going to get to be king after him. And so the Herod and his priests, they didn't know where the king was, the new baby king was, but he said to them, but if you find out, let me know, and then I'll come and I'll adore him too. Only he didn't mean that. He was telling a lie. And what he meant was, I'll go and I'll try to kill him. Well, the star came back and it led the wise men to Bethlehem, right over the crib where the child was. And they came in and they worshiped our Lord, and how happy they were to give him their gifts. And then they left. And an angel came and told the kings, don't go back to Jerusalem because that wicked king intends to kill the baby Jesus. And so they used a different route going home, and they stayed away from the capital city altogether. Well, one thing led to another, and then Herod realized that the Magi weren't going to come back, the kings weren't, and he felt that they had tricked him, and he got very angry. That's called losing your temper. You must try never to lose your temper, even though it's hard sometimes. Well, he lost his temper, and he summoned up all of his soldiers and all of his horses and all of his troops, and he sent them down to Bethlehem to kill all the baby boys, because he figured if he killed all the baby boys, he would be sure to kill the baby Jesus. Only an angel had already come to tell Saint Joseph during the night in a dream, that's how we got his messages from our Lord, during the night in a dream, that he was to get up right away, the middle of the night, and take the Blessed Mother and the Holy Child Jesus and go straight away to Egypt. Egypt was pretty far away. It was a journey of at least 3 or 4 days if you moved quickly. And off they went, and they had to cross all the sands of the desert. And it was cold, cold at night and hot during the day. And when they got to Egypt, it was a pagan country, and they came to a big city with big temples. That was called Sun City or Heliopolis. And there, all of the pagan temples fell down, and all the idols crashed down to the ground. And that's why we have a broken pillar that's symbolic in the creche this year. If you haven't seen it yet, you have to go near to the creche or the crib and take a look. You see there's a broken pillar there. That's not because somebody broke it while they were setting it up, but it represents the breaking of the idols of paganism, because our Lord has come to give us the one true religion, his Catholic Church. Well, the Blessed Mother and Saint Joseph were poor to start with, and then they had to leave everything because they were going in a hurry down to Egypt, and Our Lady had to take in laundry. She did, and Saint Joseph found odd jobs to do. And one time in their travels, there was a family that was kind to them, and they fed them and gave them a place to stay overnight. And they gave them some water so the Blessed Mother could wash the baby in the morning, the baby Jesus. And so she did, and Our Lady found out that the boy, they had a boy, was a little bit older than Jesus, but they had a boy, and he had eye problems, and he couldn't really see. So the Blessed Mother said to them very kindly, here, you take this water, and you wash your son's eyes. And so they did, the parents did, and then the boy could see, and the boy saw Jesus, and he never forgot what he looked like. So they had many other adventures, and they had to stay in Egypt for 3 years, and it was a hard life and very poor, but they were able to convert a lot of people, and all the demons and all the idols had to leave. Well, then an angel came finally and said that it was safe to go back to the Holy Land again, and that they could go up to Nazareth, and they could live there. And so they did. But in the meantime, what had happened to those little baby children, the boys? The soldiers did come, and the soldiers did kill them all. We don't know how many. And when they died, they went to a place called Limbo. Limbo is a place where you're happy, only it's not exactly heaven either. And Limbo at that time was where you waited to get to heaven, because remember, after original sin, the gates of heaven were closed until Ascension Thursday, when our Lord went back to heaven, opened them up. So when our Lord did, he took those little baby boys with him, and now they're saints still at this very day, perfectly happy, wonderful saints in heaven. Children, that's our Lord's plan for all of us. And that's the reason why we try to say our prayers and be good and obey the commandments and everything else. We try most of all to love Jesus and Mary. That's why we try to do the good things, the holy things that we do. Our Lord has a plan for us, and he wants all of us to be happy with him one day in heaven. And you must never forget that. Even when you grow up, you must still remember that. Oh, our Lord wants me to be happy with him one day in heaven for all eternity. God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.